With AWeber Landing Pages, you can build a landing page to promote your webinar in 8 easy steps. Here's how. Step 1. Pick a landing page template. AWeber's template library offers a variety of pre-built templates for your landing page. We even have one specifically for event or webinar registration. You'll start by customizing the text and images on your page, or you can even use the drag and drop editor to add new elements. For example, we can add our logo right up here and start making this page more branded like our business. Step 2, describe why someone should sign up for your webinar. It's important that you give people a reason to sign up and provide some details about your webinar. So for example, we'll let people know this is a webinar. And then we'll write out the title and give a little description as to what this webinar is going to be about, giving people a reason to sign up. We could even use the text below with these bullet points to list out further reasons that people should sign up to our webinar. We'll put in webinar details, and we'll make sure that people know what day and time it is. And then again, we'll give them a few other quick reasons why they might want to sign up. We'll let them know the event's free, that people attending will get a bonus incentive. And a few other points to convince them to click that sign up button. Step 3, show a teaser from a previous webinar. One great idea to convince people to sign up for your webinar is give them an excerpt or a taste of a previous webinar. Upload a previous webinar recording to YouTube and then add it to your page. We'll even add some text letting them know, hey, check out this excerpt from a previous webinar. Anything you can do to give people more information to help them make that decision to sign up and join your event. Step 4, create an About the Host section. Adding an About section to your landing page helps people understand who you are and a little bit about your background. You'll see that this landing page template already has a great place for us to do an About Your Host section. So we'll just replace that image. We'll update the name. There's even a section for title and position, or you can use this to write a quick description about yourself. Step 5, add testimonials from previous attendees. Testimonials are a great way to show people that others have gotten value out of your webinar. So we'll just drag some text into this bottom part of the landing page, and we'll add some testimonials we've received from previous webinar attendees. We'll type in real skills for real people. That'll be our header, make it a little bit bigger. We'll bold that, and then we'll paste in a couple of our testimonials. Put a new text block in there for those. I'll grab one testimonial. And I'll grab the other, make a little bit of space for it. Move this line down a little bit. Another thing I like to do, especially with any kind of quotes or testimonials, just highlight the text and italicize it. Makes it look really nice. This way, people can read some of what others have said about your webinar and get that incentive to join. Step 6, customize your form and call to action. Now we'll want to customize the sign-up form for the webinar. Again, this is where we're going to kind of reinforce what this is about. Letting people know, hey, after they join our webinar, they'll be an amazing chef. And we'll also customize the call to action. Sign up now is fine, but maybe we can say something like reserve my spot, adding a little bit of exclusiveness to this webinar. Lastly, we'll tag this sign-up form so that anybody filling out this form will be tagged cooking webinar. So in the future, we can send specific information just to the group who filled out this form. Step 7, make your landing page shareable. Making sure your page is shareable goes a long way in growing your audience. This template already has icons for social sharing, but if your template doesn't, or if you want to add them somewhere else, you can just drag them from the drag and drop editor. Clicking on those icons allows us to edit what's in there. We can add or even remove different social platforms, as well as change around the design of those icons. We'll make them a little bit larger so people can see them. Step 8, publish and share your page. Before we save anything, we'll give our landing page a name. This is for our records. Nobody else will see this outside of AWeber. Then we'll save. And lastly, we'll hit publish. From here, we can grab a copy of our landing page's URL, or in just a click, share on Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn. So go ahead, try this out in your AWeber account today. Don't have an account? It's absolutely free to sign up. Just click the link at the end of this video. Until next time.